George Graham walked a familiar path onto the Highbury pitch. He was an Arsenal regular for 7.5 years before leaving in 1973. But it was his key role in the 1971 double-winning side that made him a hero with the fans. They nicknamed him Stroller, and it means today's decision will be a popular one. He became Millwall manager in 1982, taking them to second division promotion last season. Millwall will receive compensation for the 12 months outstanding on his contract. Arsenal see the tough Scot as the man to bring back the glory days.
When I sort of started in the managerial game with Millwall, I think once you sort of start, you say, right, let's do well at Millwall and then let's get one at a big job like Arsenal. You hope that then, but it's just like a dream, really.
It is a precarious living, you know that only too well. Yes. Only yesterday Peter Shreve got the sack.
Yes.
Does that worry you?
No, not really, because I think if it's going to worry you to that extent, you know, don't come in it. Don't come in football. Maybe accept a coaching job, or there's lots of other jobs in football, but the managerial ones, you're either a big success and take all the plaudits, or you're a failure and you get your head chopped off.
Meanwhile, David Pleat, the Luton manager, has been having talks with the Spurs chairman Irving Scholar. Tottenham want Pleat, who's made Luton a force on a shoestring budget, to bring his success to White Hart Lane. Peter Shreve was sacked last night after 2 years in which he failed to restore Spurs to their former glories. Top managers enjoy the glamour, but as the new Arsenal boss pointed out today, their days are numbered from the start.
I think one of my ex-managers says that. It was quite funny at the time. He says it's the only job you know when you take, you know you're going to get a sack. The only thing that's not on the contract is the date. And I thought it was quite funny at the time. Maybe I won't think it's funny in the future.